We're just finding a better way to teach our kids and to have a higher pace of learning, and the whiteboard is just part of that.
Why did you decide to put all your thoughts down instead of just verbalize them to your players? You put them all down on different whiteboards.
Well, I don't think there's any magic to it. The magic, if you will, is just, you know, it's about teaching. And it's just a tool to have us teach at a higher level. The issue is transfer. Is there a lot of transfer to the activities you're doing in practice to game day? As kids learn how to make changes in their game, or they learn how to learn, they start to develop confidence by understanding what they need to do, and through sound mindful preparation, believing, hey, I can get this stuff. They can come up and actually see what we're measuring, and what gets measured gets managed, what gets managed gets done.
So how long did it take for you to become accustomed to it and comfortable with it?
It probably took about a week. You know, you can't just look at it and be like, oh my gosh, be scared. You know, you just have to take it one step at a time. The ones at the top will always stay. Those ones I think have been there for like, since Jim has been here.
Wow.
Balls have hit it, but he just like writes over it and everything.
Does it really contribute to your guys' success, do you think?
More than you think. Like, some people will walk by and be like, what are all these numbers, what are all these names? But like, we know what's going on and it helps us stay on task. So we just take it one drill at a time.